I believe that reading too many self-help books in a short time does not help. I mean, what's the benefit of just learning philosophies and then not applying them in life? Hence, I keep my pace of reading self-help really, really slow.
You are making an excuse for your slow reading speed.
No, I'm not making any excuse. I generally read 5 to 10 pages of a self-help book per day and I only finish 1 or 2 books per month. And in the last year, I read 45 books, out of which only 17 are self-help and the rest are fiction novels or biographies or memoirs. And in this video, I will talk about the best self-help books I read the last year. And I suggest you to watch this video till then because I'm sure that you will find at least one or two books, good books, to add to your reading list. So let's begin from the first book. The first book is Wherever You Go, There You Are by Jon Kabat-Zinn. It's a book on mindfulness meditation, and for those of you who don't know what mindfulness is, it's a method of meditation in which you completely be in the present. You become aware of what you are sensing and what you are feeling in the moment. That's mindfulness. And if you have tried it, you would know that mindfulness is not that easy. It's like taking a bath in a winter morning. Most of us have a habit of being somewhere else. Instead of being in the present, we are just regretting about the past or worrying about the future. Life unfolds in moments, and if you are not present in these moments, you will be unsatisfied and miss a lot of things in your life. But if you always live in the moment, you will be living a very effective life. And this book will teach you how you can be in the moment. It will tell you about various ways of mindfulness meditation, like mountain meditation, fire meditation, walking meditation, and so on. It will also teach you how you can be patient, learn the art of letting go, and be satisfied with what you have. Quite philosophical, but powerful. The second book is Death, an Inside Story by Sadhguru. It's a book on the science of life and death. You know that death is a topic which science has failed to explain and we don't talk about it. Death is the most certain thing in our life and nobody talks about it, which kind of amazes me. Thankfully, this book will help you understand life and death. It will answer questions like what is death? What is its importance? Is it good or bad? What happens after death? Do ghosts exist? How we can prepare for a better death? Importance of Indian death rituals and many things. However, there are some things in the book which are too fantastic to believe and I could not believe them. But the book is worth reading because it will remind you that you are going to die. And believe me, it will set you free. The next one is Everybody Writes by Anne Handley. And this book will help you write better. Writing has become an essential skill nowadays. From WhatsApp messages, Instagram captions, LinkedIn posts, emails, to writing love letters to your crush, writing is an important skill to maintain relationships, share your views, and influence people. And most of us think that writing is easy. No, it's not. Just like speaking, writing is a communication skill that needs guidance and a lot of practice to master. And that's where this book will help you. It will teach you the basics of writing and help you make your writing engaging, funny, simple, as well as powerful. It also contains some rules of grammar and shares views of experienced writers. So yeah, this book will make you an influential writer. The next is Yourself by Gary John Bishop. It's a motivational book, and if you feel hopeless, tired, bored, or aimless, this book will be a great choice to read. There are some powerful lessons in the book which will propel you to take action. The book will help you see things differently, make you mentally tough and wise. This book will make you mature. And when I finished reading this book, I felt that, you know, I have become wise and mature. Wait a minute. What's that? I got Hajmola candy in my pocket. The next book is Big Magic by Elizabeth Gilbert. I have talked so many times about this book. I even made a video sharing 3 lessons from this. And if you want to watch it, I will put the link in the description. Now to complete this video, I will tell you a few things about this book. Big Magic is about creative living, and this book will help you if you want to be an artist or want to live a creative life. Elizabeth Gilbert is the author of the best-selling book Eat, Pray, Love, and she has shared many incidents from her own life to explain what habits and attitudes you need to be a successful artist. She will teach you how you can be creative, work persistently, have patience, and get incredible ideas for creative projects to create something amazing. The next book is Deep Work by Cal Newport. Again, I have made a video on this book sharing 5 lessons. I will put the link in the description. Now let me tell you a few things about this book. Deep Work is about productivity and focus. The author, Cal Newport, says that with the development of technology, the world is becoming more and more advanced each day, which is not a new thing. And in this competitive world, if you can't work with focus or do deep work, then you will be useless to the economy and soon be replaced by the technology. But in this world of social media and phone notifications, working deep is really difficult. That's why this book will help you. First, it will tell you the importance of deep work, and then it will help you integrate deep work into your daily routine so that you get the most out of the limited 24 hours you have every day. The next book is Daring Greatly by Brené Brown. Again, I have made a detailed video on this book sharing 5 lessons. The video is so detailed that I fear I will get copyright claims from the publishing house. Anyway, this book is about vulnerability and shame. The book debunks some myths about vulnerability. It will help you accept your imperfections, be comfortable with shame and criticism, be brave and more alive. The author researched for 12 years and interviewed many people to write this masterpiece. And it's a somewhat rare book. You won't find many books on vulnerability and shame. So the book is very enlightening and completely worth reading. The next book is, forgot the name, How to Develop Self-Confidence and Influence People by Public Speaking by Dale Carnegie. As the title says, this book will help you if you want to be good at public speaking. Now I understand that you can't learn public speaking by just reading books. You have to go to the stage for that. But this book is a great place to start. It will teach you how you can make your speech interesting as well as influential. It will teach you how you should prepare for your speech. Open and close a talk, capture the attention of the audience, deliver in an interesting way, be confident while speaking, and so on. It's a classic book published in, I think, 1956, and it contains many examples of great speakers from the past like Abraham Lincoln, Woodrow Wilson, Theodore Roosevelt, Benjamin Franklin, and so on. Carnegie also shares examples from his life and his students to make things easy to understand. The next book is 4-Hour Workweek by Tim Ferriss. It's very popular and controversial book. It's about lifestyle design, or designing your life in such a way that you live it to the fullest by doing what you love. To be honest, I found some of the things slightly exaggerated, but mostly it was helpful because I learned many new things about living an effective life. This book will teach you how and why you should put yourself in uncomfortable situations, focus in your work without getting distracted, save time for yourself, and follow some unreasonable but effective paths to earn money. In other words, 4-hour work week will show you a different way of living. So if anytime you get bored with the one you are living right now, you know which book to read. The last and one of the best self-help books I read in 2021 is Ego is the Enemy by Ryan Holiday. The message of the book is the title, Ego is the Enemy. It's an enlightening read which will tell you many things like what ego is, how dangerous it could be, why you should control it, how you should control it, why you should be humble, and so on. The book contains many real-life examples of people who got destroyed because of their ego or who lived a heroic life because of their humility. And in case if you are thinking that you don't have any ego problem or this book is not for you, I must warn you that you may be wrong, because we all have an ego and it controls our life without our realization. That's what makes it a powerful enemy, and this book is all about how you can defeat this enemy. So these are the 10 best self-help books I read last year, that is 2021. Each of these books will help you learn a particular thing or master a particular skill. So choose those books which interest you the most. I hope it was helpful. Let me know in the comments which of these books you have already read and what you think about them. You can also subscribe to this YouTube channel where I mostly talk about books. And if you are still watching this video, I'm really grateful. Thanks for staying with me. Meet you in the next video.